This forecast is powered by Johnson's Appliances and Bedding, your local independent appliances and bedding retailers. Visit us in-store or online at johnsonsappliances.net.
Well, it's always so nice to see you guys up and early with your bright, shining faces. The weekend's right around the corner, so that should have you excited. And look, I know Saturday is not going to be the nicest day. We have some adverse weather conditions coming our way with rain showers, perhaps a wintry mix for some of you, some wind. It's going to be Sunday, don't get me wrong, is going to be a much better day. We'll get there in a second, but let's focus on the here and the now. We got high pressure up to our north. That's going to allow the winds to come in off of the ocean out of the northeast. This area of disturbed weather out to our south and west over the higher elevations of the Virginias, likely some snow showers out there, but that's going to have no impact on our weather here at home. It's quite chilly out there. You know what? No, we'll call it what it is. It's cold, all right? Temperatures were allowed to drop down into the teens for some of you because we had the bright, clear, starry skies overnight and not much in terms of a wind. Perfect conditions for what we call radiational cooling. So any heat that's able to be built up through the course of the day radiates or escapes through the upper levels of the atmosphere. And then this is your result. 18 right now in Mays Landing, or 17 at Mays Landing, 18 in Hamilton, 21 down in Cape May. We have a little bit of a breeze and it's making it feel like we are in the middle teens right now. At the bus stop, make sure the little ones are bundled up and they have layers. We'll be in the middle 20s over the next few hours with increasing clouds through the course of the morning and into the afternoon. Other than that, it's not going to be a fantastic day. Not as nice as yesterday and a little bit on the cooler side as well. So here comes those snow showers over West Virginia, maybe over southern Pennsylvania. Then they'll fizzle out. They are not going to get here, though I wish they would. Temperatures today, 40 in Hamilton and Bridgeton, 39 for Atlantic City, 36 up in Toms River, 34 up in the Edison area. And again, partly cloudy to start, clouds eventually increase through the day, and some of you will become overcast. 24 tonight, mainly cloudy skies, a hair warmer than last night. With the cloud cover, I do not foresee us falling down into the teens, so you don't need two or three blankets. I was really bundled up last night, so you don't have to do that tonight. 46 tomorrow, clouds and some sun, and temperatures are certainly going to be on the rise. We'll end up in the middle 40s, east-northeast winds at just about 5 to 10 miles an hour. Here comes that storm system. By Friday night, it's still down to our southwest over Virginia. And you see in the higher elevations in the mountainous areas, there will likely be some snow. Could pick up some light measurable snow, but we're more concerned about this rain. Of course, it's going to be too warm for any kind of wintry precip for most of South Jersey. If it tracks the way I think it will, it's not running into a whole lot of cold air available, so it'll continue to slide up the coast, and by Saturday morning, we're likely seeing some rain showers, rain snow line probably to the north and west of Philadelphia if the precipitation reaches all the way that far north and west. Looks like a period of steady rain possible late morning, early afternoon, and then it gets out of here. So it's not an all-day event. It does look like it's going to escape up in the New England probably mid to late afternoon. Follow me on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. It's at Nor'easter Nick. You can also download my brand new updated Norcast weather app. Just search Nor'easter Nick in your Apple or Android store. 7-day forecast after that storm's out of here on Saturday. Things improve a little bit on Sunday at 48 degrees. And then next week, we have a couple opportunities of some light rain, but we'll take it with temperatures in the upper 50s.